Hello, I'm Subhash Taluri, and what we have is a solution with Cox Communications looking at intelligent service health using generative AI. We built a forensic tool to help network operations center and field technicians to reduce mean time to detect, diagnose, and remediate network issues. Today, it takes about 8 hours altogether. We reduce that to a matter of seconds. We have done that in a two-step process. One is we build the service health platform, and the platform taps into every operational platform of Cox Communications, looking at data coming from routers, switches, and modems, and it's streamed into AWS Data Lake. The service health platform is powered by a custom-built Angular UI, which is looking at, we have a network filter through which we look at the head-end site all the way to the node level. And at the node level, we are showing all the homes that are connected to the node, looking at service experience, customer interactions, offline modem activity, and on top of the service health, which gives a real-time state of the network, we have built a conversational UI, which is powered by generative AI. Imagine we have a network technician who needs to perform or diagnose an active event or troubleshoot a network issue. At that point, he would come into this service health platform, use the conversational UI to answer freeform text about historic work that was done on the network element. So at this point, the NOC engineer or a technician asking that question to the analytics dashboard, the solution, the response is orchestrated by AWS Lambda. The language model understands the semantics of the user question, interprets that, and taps into the right data source, the orchestration which is done by AWS Lambda. What you see here is a concise summary. When we retrieve the context from the original data source, it goes into Amazon Bedrock Anthropic Claude Model 2. We are summarizing about 50,000 tokens of text into less than 200 tokens in a chronological manner, which is concise, which is meaningful, and factually accurate. Behind the scenes, we have done extensive prompt engineering that systematically filters out noise, such as automatic tickets that were open and closed, which is something that the technician does not need to know. And then further along, we have enabled Q&A. So what now happens is a technician can ask further questions. For example, list all the tickets that were raised. So at that point, we are listing all the tickets. This enables a drill down fashion of diagnosing an active event by taking the network ticket and understanding the specifics of that ticket. So going forward, we have also used a multi-rack design pattern where a traditional rack would tap into one source. In this case, we are looking at multiple sources, taking that information into context of a language model, understanding the semantics of the question. So what you see here is the summary of telemetry events. At that point, we go into network telemetry, retrieve that context. Further along, let's assume that the technician has identified an amplifier to be an issue. So at that point, a freeform question could be that, are any of the reported outages that are related to an amplifier fault? So we are now trying to correlate between remedy journal entries and network telemetry events. And we have a response from the GenAI system that's trying to identify if there are any correlations. And further along, a technician can ask for troubleshooting steps, for example, of an amplifier fault. In that case, we bring that troubleshooting guides and the information from the troubleshooting information into context to answer that question. So effectively, what we have done is, for the customer benefit, we have effectively reduced the diagnostic interval from hours to minutes. Today, Cox technicians take up to a day, about 8 hours, to pull information from multiple data sources and diagnose and remediate active events. We reduce that to a matter of seconds. We have a scalable low latency design. The backend architecture that we have we have differentiated between RAG runtime and pipeline. That means any of the historic summaries can be pre-populated, stored in a vector database such as Amazon OpenSearch, And then at runtime, to a user question, the response is only firing through the vector space. And effectively, we have reduced the latency to less than 10 seconds. So thank you for watching this demo. I hope you have great takeaways from this. And we hope to implement this with many of your customers and partners.